I wanted to leave the past behind me. My mother didn't let me. She spoke German to me because she said, if my father ever got out, how are you going to talk to him? I was obsessed with becoming American. I was a super patriot. Anybody in our neighborhood who ever said an unkind word about the United States, I would stomp on him. But it left a deep sense of what we had been through in me, and it didn't come back full force until I was a reporter for the New York Times. And in 1956, they sent me to Vienna to help cover the Hungarian Revolution. And within a week of my landing there, the Russians suppressed that revolution. And I was down at the border, and in the middle of the night, people started streaming across the potato fields in cold weather, which was exactly the experience I had had when we were dumped on the border of Poland. And it kindled a passion in me about the sight of all this that I think some of the most passionate dispatches I ever wrote in my long career were written in those weeks. Ever after running around the world, the Jews who were being oppressed in Russia when I was a correspondent there, the clampdown by Castro on Cubans and depriving them of their freedoms. I think the forced transfer of populations is one of the great unwritten stories. Through the 20th century, horrendous horrors were perpetrated, and I think people who live in a stable society, relatively stable as the United States has been, have no appreciation for the psychological dislocation, aside from the physical hardship and the poverty that such transfers involve. All of these things resonated very powerfully with me, and so a piece of me was never stopped being a refugee.